If you've been looking at your firewall logs lately, you may have seen a relatively new protocol called QUIC. Like me, you've probably wondered, what is it? Is it relevant? And more importantly, does it pose any security threat to the network? Let's take a look. The QUIC protocol was originally released by Google in 2012 as a general-purpose transport layer protocol. It's heavily used between the Chrome web browser and Google servers. This has now become an IETF standard, and other vendors, especially web browsers, have started supporting it. QUIC's primary purpose is to improve the performance of connection-oriented web applications, that is, web apps that currently use TCP. In this way, QUIC is kind of like a competitor to TCP. To improve performance, QUIC creates independent multiplexed UDP connections between two endpoints. That is, it doesn't just use a single stream of data, it will use several at once. Each of these streams is independent of each other, so while one stream may drop packets, the others will not. How is this useful? Think of loading a web page. There are usually several items that need loading, like HTML code, scripts, images, and more. When the connection between the browser and the server is multiplexed, the client does not need to wait for one of them to finish loading before downloading the next. You may be thinking, doesn't HTTP version 2 already do this? It does use multiple streams, yes. But it contains these within a single TCP connection. That means that one stream will still be able to affect the quality of another stream. If TCP needs to resend missing packets, all streams need to wait for this to complete before they can get on with their job. And because of this similarity between the two, mapping HTTP over QUIC is often called HTTP version 3. Other benefits that multiplexing brings is the ability to monitor each stream. This then enables the protocol to prioritize some streams over others, which reduces latency and helps avoid congestion. Additionally, QUIC uses encryption to provide TLS equivalent security. So now the big question, is this protocol insecure, or is there some sort of security risk that QUIC poses to us? At the time that I'm making this video, many security experts are recommending that you block the QUIC protocol. This won't lose functionality, as browsers will fall back to TCP and TLS. Why do they recommend this? It's not necessarily insecure, but there are a few concerns. First, many still consider this to be experimental. It hasn't had time to prove itself yet. Also, changes may still be made to the protocol, revealing new security concerns. In addition, while still providing TLS equivalent encryption, it is still proprietary encryption. It simply hasn't had the same amount of scrutiny as other encryption types. And finally, many firewalls do not handle QUIC as web traffic and will not inspect it accordingly. This means they can't adequately check for malware being downloaded, can't enforce safe search, can't log web access, and can't filter by URL. Many of these things will just require time to resolve. By the time you're watching this, it's possible that this recommendation has changed, so make sure you do some up-to-date research. Overall, the QUIC protocol offers some enhancements to the traffic that's being sent over the internet. And once it's had time to reach maturity, it should be a welcome addition.